The U.S. Air Force is now developing the first prototype of the new B-21 Raider bomber. The B-21 Raider is envisaged to be a super stealthy bomber which will be able to penetrate the most sophisticated air defenses for decades into the future and be able to take out high-value enemy targets without the rival even knowing it was there in the first place. The bomber will have a very long range and high payload capacity to carry conventional and nuclear weapons. B-21 is expected to replace the Air Force's aging fleets of B-1, B-2, and B-52 strategic bombers, which have an average age of 27 years. Air Force Chief of Staff General David Goldfein told an audience at an event hosted by the Mitchell Institute for Aerospace Studies, "We're closely monitoring the build of the additional test aircraft and associated software to support the first flight." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes America's upcoming B-21 Raider superbomber. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank or aircraft and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. B-21 is being developed under the Long Range Strike Bomber (LRSB) program. A request for proposal to develop the aircraft was issued in July 2014. On the 25th of October 2013, Boeing and Lockheed Martin announced they're teaming up for the LRSB. The other participant was Northrop Grumman. On the 27th of October 2015, the U.S. Department of Defense awarded the development contract to Northrop Grumman. The deciding factor in the selection of the Northrop design was cost. The Air Force plans to purchase 80 to 100 LRSB aircraft. The initial value of the contract is $21.4 billion, but the deal could eventually be worth up to $80 billion. Aerial denial and anti-access (ADA2) systems deny U.S. forces the ability to come within hundreds or even thousands of miles of an enemy's territory. Today, these high-end capabilities are being developed and deployed by countries like China and Russia, but they will soon be available to others as well. These capabilities include advanced integrated air defense systems with long-range engagement capabilities, able to target and shoot down aircraft from hundreds of miles away, as well as increasingly capable ballistic missiles that can put America's fixed installations and even U.S. carrier strike groups at risk throughout an entire region. A country with a strong ADA2 capability has basically created an invisible fortress wall that can be pushed out thousands of miles from its territorial borders. The most potent example of this is S-400 Triumph. The S-400 is an anti-aircraft weapon system developed in the 1990s by Russia's Almaz Central Design Bureau as an upgrade to the S-300 family. It's been in service with the Russian Armed Forces since 2007. It can track 300 targets simultaneously and engage 36 of those at any one time. S-400 is a fatal threat to everything except the most advanced stealth fighters and bombers. This basically renders all the fourth-generation fighters like F-16s and F-18s obsolete. Only the F-22 Raptor, F-35 Lightning II stealth fighter, and B-2 Spirit stealth bomber would be able to operate inside areas protected by S-400. But even those aircraft could be challenged if there were enough S-400 batteries operating as part of an integrated air defense network. Also, it's to be noted that F-22 and F-35 don't have a huge payload capacity, and B-2 Spirit is available in limited numbers. Only 21 were manufactured. This is where B-21 Raider will come into the picture. The B-21 will be a critical part of America's air power in the future, as it will be able to take on these current and emerging ADA-2 capabilities of the rivals. B-21 will be very much an enabler for other air combat systems. It will fly deep into enemy airspace to take out the rivals' ADA-2 capability and render them partially defenseless. Apart from tactical and strategic bombing missions, the Raider is expected to be able to conduct surveillance, reconnaissance, intelligence, and electronic attack. U.S. Air Force had revealed the concept art and designs for the B-21 sometime back. The new B-21 Raider looks very similar to its B-2 Spirit. Actually, it will look startlingly similar to the original Advanced Strategic Penetration Aircraft, ASPA, and the later Advanced Technology Bomber concept from the 1980s that ultimately resulted in the B-2. B-21 Raider will go one step ahead of B-2 Spirit when it comes to stealth. Initially, B-2 Spirit was designed for high-altitude penetration missions, but the Spirit was redesigned later in the game to operate at low altitudes. The redesign caused a decrease in range and payload, as well as a larger radar cross-section. B-21 will have no such limitations, and its stealth characteristic is intended to not only elude higher-frequency engagement radars that allow air defenses to actually target an aircraft, but also counter lower-frequency surveillance radar, which, though can't be used for tracking, can be used for detection. Invisibility to lower-frequency surveillance radar is important too, since though these cannot be used to guide the missiles, they can be used by the enemy to direct warplanes to the vicinity of B-21 for a possible interception. B-21's super stealthy profile will be made possible by three enhancements. 1. A refinement of the external contours will be done. Stealth aircraft like B-2 is designed so that there's no sharp edges or protruding elements and has smooth curvature. The weapons are also carried internally. This kind of design deflects the radar signals away from the emitting radar, and it doesn't receive back the signals. This way, the radars are basically blinded. Though B-2 is very well designed, two decades later, there's a scope of significant improvement. 2. Even with the stealth profile, some radar signal can't be diverted away from the source. This is where radar-absorbing material, RAM, comes into play. RAM covers the external parts of the aircraft so that radar signal is absorbed and don't reflect back. B-21 will use new RAM that will utilize state-of-the-art coating technologies. 3. B-2 has an engine that's internal to the airframe. The idea of this design, along with different methods of exhaust control, is to reduce the heat signature. This makes the aircraft have more or less similar thermal profile as the surrounding air, and it doesn't pop up when an infrared IR sensor tries to detect it. The B-21 will have more efficient engines that run cooler and will have a better way to cool down the exhaust air. The overall better thermal management will make its IR profile much better. Apart from this stealth, the avionics, sensor suite, and weapons package all will see considerable enhancements. B-21 is designed so that it can accommodate new technologies as they become available. When the proposal to develop the aircraft was issued in 2014, the requirements were laid down. The U.S. Air Force has now completed the design review after going through proposed aircraft subsystems, configurations, and weapons. This phase validates that the design will be able to meet the requirements. The next phase will be engineering and prototyping, where the concept will actually be built and a virtual design comes to real life. Scheduled to enter service in the mid-2020s, the Raider will be able to take off from American mainland and is expected to strike even well-protected targets anywhere on Earth. It's interesting to note that the main rivals of the United States, Russia and China, have not fielded an operational stealth bomber till now. It's likely that Raider, which is America's second stealth bomber, will be deployed before the rivals manage to deploy their first one. This clearly demonstrates the lead the U.S. has when it comes to fielding cutting-edge military tech.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.